Hey guys, this is Bill out in the torch shop, and I'm going to make a hummingbird feeder for you today. It's 8 degrees outside this morning, but it's supposed to warm up, and it's a beautiful sunny day here in Montana in late February. But spring's in the air. I can hear some birds out there chirping away, and won't be long before the hummingbirds will be on their way back up here. So we better get busy and give them a feeder, right? Heat this up a little bit, press it, just give it a little bit of a flat base to work with. This particular color is pretty easy working. It behaves a little unpredictably when it's encased, like in a marble, but it's done pretty well when it's thinner and blown pieces. But it doesn't have any compatibility issues or cracking issues that I've ever had. So I'm going to throw a little bit of silver fume on there just to give it a little variety from one side to the other. And then build up our clear. That color will be a layer inside the middle of the clear. Gonna just heat on the shoulder here and start this process of pulling out the ribbon cane. So to me, aesthetically, a good twist size ratio, one turn of the ribbon cane is about the same as the cross section, the diameter. So maybe it's not exactly a full turn, it's maybe each half turn. So in the pattern, as you're looking across it, it's sort of little boxes. Thank you. open up the end of the tube here. Catch our blow tube. Up a little bit. Get some color all the way around, pull a little bit. So I want to do some gold fume first. Get our flame dialed down here. I'm oxidizing fairly small flame. Trying to introduce our gold slowly so it doesn't pop off of there. Yeah, it popped off of there. But there was another piece of gold left. So now we're going to put down the ribbon cane that we made. Get a little bit of this off the end. There's not much color in it. Dragon's blood. It's a nice red. One little stringer will actually add quite a lot of color to the finished piece. Handle on the back end.